if you need a year-end statement for your giving in 2019, please contact the office. Due to the tax laws changing, apparently not everybody needs the other announcement is that Ms. Martha Cook, that she was a member here at our church that attended the 8 o'clock service, she's passed away, and the funeral will be held tomorrow here at the church at 11 o'clock. I also want to let y'all know that I do believe that there are two churches that are working with Sunday supply, so being shared. And it's been quite busy. Anyway. The boiler has been repaired. There's a bunch of announcements in the leaflets that you can look at. Any help, again, with volunteering from the food pantry or the thrift shop would always be appreciated. We also have the floors completed from the breakage of the water main. The water main in the archives broke, as you know, and so all three of the places have been restored. So the auditorium has a new looking floor, and so does the archives and the property. And it looks gorgeous, and so it's a blessing to have had that kind of ability to restore those. But that means that we have to start putting the stuff from the archives back into the archives. And in order to do that, I think we need to start documenting it properly before we put it in. So I'm going to be looking for any volunteers that can come and help me to begin that process. I know that there's some people that can help better at home. I'm going to have them. I'm going to put up a workstation up there in the archives. And hopefully, if you're able to come in and help with the sorting and such, that would be great. I'm looking right now to order some supplies. Also, if you're mobily impaired, because I know it's up on the third floor, come into the depot side. We can let you in, and then you can take the elevator. We have a lot of stuff that we have to put back into the archive and make sure it's maintained well. So I just put that out there. Also, if you're interested in any of the ministries that are vacant, we have a welcoming ministry I'd like to restart. We are also in need of someone to help facilitate the regrouping of our stewardship committee, because stewardship is more than just a pledge campaign at the end of the year. We also need people. I'm hopefully going to be starting up a capital campaign next year. This year is the research and the time to apply for some grants. So if anybody wants to participate in the preservation of our windows and chancel, and engage that capital campaign, that would be greatly appreciated. Because we can always get stuff done. And if you hear of any grants that are going to help the downtown area, get the application into the office. We missed the one for the $10 million, but I know that there's more coming, so I need to get it. And it's one thing to know it, but it's another thing to have something in hand to complete. So, please, if you hear any other grants through the city for the facade, because everybody uses this picture of our church. Google any website, and it has Utica in it. Our church is on that page. And so I'm going to be a little bit of a mouthpiece when it comes to repair our steeple. And I'm trying to do that without a capital campaign. Okay? So keep all that in your prayers. Let's gather our thoughts and minds into the worship of Almighty God. Our service continues on page 355. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be the Lord, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee, and worthy magnify our holy name, your holy name. Hear what the Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Such the fast that I choose, day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and the lion in sackcloth and ashes? Do you call this a fast, a day acceptable? To the Lord, is not this fast to let choose to lose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, and bring the homeless poor into your house when you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall not break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring out quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call and say, here I am. If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your food be like the new day. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places, and make your bones strong. And you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt, and you shall rise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach and restorer of streets to live in. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus Christ and Him crucified.
And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet among the mature, we do speak wisdom, though it is not a wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age, who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages of our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But, as it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him. These things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows what is truly human, except the human spirit that is within? So also no one comprehends what is truly God's except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the Spirit of the world, but the Spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. And we speak of these things in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual things to those who are spiritual. Those who are unspiritual do not receive the gifts of God's Spirit, for they are foolishness to them, and they are unable to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. Those who are spiritual discern all things, and they are themselves subject to no one else's scrutiny. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
But if the salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? If it is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot? You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on a lampstand. And it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until it is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter.
Vedea dacă îmi s-o acolo de matei cu ea să vârșită trebuie zi, tu vedea ele de mi-o apoi, dar o, mi-mi i da homi dana, hoki vădă vrubile, tu ură do la vată, uțe, va câti cu ea la cu, do, pata ea tiză la mi-o, tu vedea ele de mi-o apoi, tu vădă, vârbui, cu vădă, cu să dobuni, cu vădă, de vădă, Wahre toh mude do paale na pala uba doima mi paale mude lo hoku do kochoni wale tim kele lo bine do ita kone dugu kocho lo parjo menya di do duti ba tu madagi do kishon lo tu ba ulang kone di tato tato mige widi de pa kone mige ये महागोली दुर्जोगली तमिबा ये महागोबा मी ये मादरो कोलो अगेरी इसीबा तेबा दुर्जोई मुखुरो कोटु दीमुदी लोकी तिबारो लेला तमालो फ्लसी तफ्ल मी अन्नको अन्नर मी तफ्लो लोको कजो तिबा खेलो हागोबा कोलोबा मादरी लो हेरा माला अलित्रि खापचा तमालो शिक्तर ची लर्ताये लानी लोतोलो बागियो दीने तो तेरागानी कबाटा कोला शिक्तर लर्मुगो गोमुगो मिने हेरा माला तो निवे लोतोलो बागियो कबाटा कोला अटुल लर्मुगो गोमुगो रीडी असीबा देवादुला तुतातोलो मिना देवा Wakili dokap Parisel tak tahu apa lo, itu lagi baju muka bom muka.
The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus in film and thematic really ruined a lot of things for me. Now I see Jesus in every film. But what's interesting is I was sitting with Bruce the other day and Teresa, and my son was watching the movie Home. And it's a cute little movie about these alien race called the Boobs. And it's played by Joan Parsons, the person that plays the main character. Anyways, this movie is just a great little film, and I think it's the cutest thing. But one of the things that struck me, and it just came to me now sitting here, was that in the end, he was running towards the danger. Because the Boob were the kind of people that would run away from that which they feared. The king of the Boob was the best at running away, and that's why he ruled. But this little Boob had a different view. He wanted neighbors. He wanted friends. He ended up becoming a fugitive. Sound familiar? And he ran to the danger. See, Richard, you're up there. Fun rumor. It does sound like the way in which Christians are called to live. Jesus didn't walk away or flee from what was to come. He walked towards it. His ministry led him to a place where he laid down his life for his friends. And this move, in the end, looked like he sacrificed his life to save the generation of these aliens that were coming after him. And I can't help but think that that's the way that we as Christians are called to live, to boldly go. You know what I want to say. But we know that lots of people went there before us. Anyways, to boldly go out into the world to proclaim the good news, to do what God calls us to do. This passage in Isaiah literally tells us to stop doing it the way we think we should be doing it and doing it the way God wants us to. So it says here, it says, if you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger and the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom shall be like new day. So basically, stop pointing your finger at people. Stop using the ways of the world to express the moralities of Christianity that have no call on our lives. We are called to feed the poor, to be with our neighbor, to love as we have been loved. And every commandment is relational in some way. And then we hear about this fasting, and there's a lot of people that fast on their own in order to receive an answer to their prayer, usually according to what the world says we need. Right? So I do think that the discipline of fasting and prayer is an awesome thing to do, but I also believe that it has to be grounded in a desire to be in relationship with God, grounded in the desire to increase an understanding of the wisdom of God, so that we know how to boldly go out into the world as the light, to feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, especially to clothe the naked. I don't know. Sorry. And so I think when we talk about fasting, because this is the fast I want. I want you to loose the bonds of injustice. I want you to combat all these things so that people know that you are my people. So, right now we get a lot of finger pointing Christians. And we wonder why our churches are empty. Because that's not of God. Sure, God convicts us when we do things wrong. Sin does exist, and the power of evil is in this world. But God doesn't say, no, 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 no. God says, come to me. Turn. And if you notice, his arms are wide open. And that's important. We all have the ability to change from our dependency on the world, for the fears that keep us from God. To feel God's peace isn't him miraculously healing, but us knowing that God did not will us to walk with, that God walks with us and inspires us to show faith and courage, so that when people witness, us in this way, they think, oh, there must be something to that. And it's true. As I sit here and preach, I know you can think of someone in your life whose faith is so strong that you could not believe in the midst of their life that the peace could be in them. Because life's not easy. It's not. And I think when we get so caught in one way of understanding how we worship God without examining the other way, we don't feel blessed. For instance, I have always been one that prefers communal worship. My dedication to the Lord, my prayer life, everything is so much easier if there's other people around. If I have a role, if I get to be this priest, you know? My individual one, where I pray by myself, is hard. But I know I need to nurture and ground myself in prayer in order to continue to hear the Spirit to do the work that God calls me. And it's the same with those people who are very comfortable in fasting alone and praying and taking on an individual perspective of faith. It might be easier. And it might be more difficult to get into the community and to share that outwardly. I know as Anglicans have met a few that have a difficulty expressing it outwardly. Ask someone to pray around the spot, it's not always responded to as easily. And that's okay. When we don't nurture ourselves, the salt starts to not taste so salty. Right? Think about it. What does salt do? A ton of things. Sodium is probably one of the very first elements of the earth. Let's be real. The oceans are full of it. Right? My guess is during the time of Jesus, salt would have been an economic support. Because the battle in Jerusalem, in Israel, well, you have to remember, back then, the passage that allowed you to the east for trade to break through Israel. And you wonder why people were fighting over it. It had, you know, besides the blessing of who inherited the Ishmael or Isaac, that argument will always be there too. Civil rivalry in the Bible is rampant. But it was also an economic center. And so the ways of the world dictated how people were treating each other back then. And then the Christians and the Jewish people that believed in the Messiah, even the Jewish people without believing in the Messiah, were called to a particular way of interacting with the world that gave glory to God. But the world is chaotic. The world will continually challenge all the principles we are called to uphold as followers of Jesus. And when we don't examine our relationship with God in prayer as individuals and as a group, we don't become the salt of the earth. Salt is so important. It cleans things. It prevents an infection sometimes. Right? If you don't have anything else to fix your cut, pour some salt water on it. We gargle with it. We live and use it so we don't slip and fall out of sight. We cook with it. And it's part of our body. If our salt levels go down, what happens? And I think that spiritually is the case as well. So as we move forward, are we following the ways of the world? Or are we letting God's gifts shine through us? Are we using all that we've been given as a blessing to share the good news with those around us? Are we praying, developing a relationship with God to make sure that the salt is continually replenished? You don't stop drinking water, so don't stop praying. Don't stop loving your neighbor. Don't stop obeying God. And don't stop the Spirit from entering into your mind and convicting you and challenging you to turn back towards God. Because when you turn, I can guarantee you're going to see the face of Christ. And his arms are going to be wide open. And he's going to say, I love you. Come to me. Let's pray. thank you for all the ways that you have called us to be your children. We thank you for sending your Son into this world as an example of the fast you wish for us to give. Help us to have that bravery to go into the danger of the world and change it through love and action. We pray, O Heavenly God, that we would never run away from the challenges that you give us, and that we will always know your presence through your Spirit and our faith in the Son you sent. In the name of Jesus. Our service continues on page 358 with our faith in a God who calls us and makes us his or her own. Let's confess. We believe in one God.
Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We give you thanks for the grace and peace that comes to us from God, our Creator, and our Savior Jesus Christ, offering to you our gratefulness. and we're invited to add your thanksgivings. We will exalt you, O God, our King,
and praise your name forever and ever.
Raise your eternal life to those who died, especially Dr. Tofi and Hannity, that they may be blameless in the days of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
Let their trust in you.
We pray also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, who is the passion and forgiveness of our sins, knowing on the limits of God and of God, and so hold our righteous by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Gracious and wonderful God, you have called us to be salt in the bitter world of evil, to be a light in the shadow of injustice and oppression. Grant us strength and courage to bring your light to all who live among us and beyond us, that the whole world may be enlightened to see your good works and to give glory to you, our infinite God, through the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
Give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For by water and the Holy Spirit, you have made us a new people in Jesus Christ our Lord, to show forth your glory in all the world. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn and proclaim the glory of your name. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ is
God. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption of God in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death and resurrection and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be your people, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at that last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your kingdom. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, your Son, by him and with him, unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours. Almighty Father, now